Good day, everybody. Connor McIver, RE/MAX's Paris 911 team. Welcome to our daily real estate radio show. You know, we're a couple days away from the New Year's, 2015, so I'm excited. Today is going to be show number 2014.364. So 365 days in the year, a couple more shows left today and tomorrow. Today is our Travel Tuesdays broadcast. This is where we get into what matters, how to search for real estate online, how to find values, the best places to go, and why you would want those kind of resources. In addition to that, let me give you some background on me. Of course, I'm Connor McIver. I'm with a team, real estate team, headquartered in Santa Clarita Valley. My team is known as Paris 911. Paris is for a person, the team leader, one of them. I was the 911 working LAPD for a long time, so there you go. Paris911.com is our URL with RE/MAX Brokerage. Again, Santa Clarita Valley, Valencia, Greater LA. Anything you need, let us know. All right, so yesterday we did our Market Mondays. That's our recap. We do have a daily real estate radio show. You can find that at our main site at Paris911.com. Go there, you can listen to today's episode, past episodes. And within every episode, I give specific intel related to the local markets. So we talk about what's going on. We talk about buyers' needs, sellers' needs. And we talk about listings. We talk about all the information out there that is relevant to the real estate world, the real estate searching world, the real estate buying and selling world, so on and so forth. So right now, Travel Tuesday's broadcast is going to bring us to a site that we put together not too long ago, known as MLSBest.com, MLSBest.com. You go there, very simple URL. MLS, of course, stands for Multiple Listing Service, best because I definitely believe it is. Our clients also give it raving reviews. It is a mobile-friendly search. So if you have an iPad or an iPhone, an Android, tablet, any kind of those items, and they are mobile in nature, of course, as I just mentioned, you can go to MLSBest.com, and it will adjust and let you search for all of the available real estate currently for sale. A couple other options, whenever you are searching online, one of the things you're going to find out there is you're going to run into listings that are no longer for sale. And I know, believe it or not, there are a lot of websites out there that are built around monetizing your personal information. The first time you reach out and say, have a question, or I'd like to know more about this property, or send me more information, you're doomed. You have just entered the spam channel. And that being the case, it could be a while before you get all those people that are paying for your personal information off your back. When you're searching, best place to do it is on a local resource. So what we've done on MLSBest.com, of course, after you search for a little bit, the only people that will see any inquiry, personal information via registration, is going to be me, myself, and I. And I'll be the one that contacts you if you do have a question. But if you don't have a question and you're just searching and you register on the system to get those email updates, then you don't have to worry because I'm not going to even reach out to you. But when you are ready, please, you know, of course, you'll know where that source is coming from. None of your personal information is going to get sold or traded, otherwise change hands. Everything's going to stay directly with yours truly. What we did, and the reason why we did it, is we put together a system on that particular site, MLS Best, that will only show you active real estate listings. Well, gee, Connor, don't I want to see the ones in backup too? Because those sellers, by choosing that status, are indicating that they want additional viewings and additional offers to be written because they want a backup plan. Maybe they're not super happy with the offer that they received. They still want to keep it open. Well, unfortunately, that's not always the case. And in fact, that case happens to be a minority of the time. It doesn't happen that often. Most people, when they put their property in backup, the sellers actually don't even know. It's the agent that's choosing that particular field. So that being the case, the agent is choosing backup because it still shows the website as being fully active that particular property as being fully active on some of those real estate channels out there. Remember those big real estate syndication websites I talk about on previous shows, even mentioned a little bit today? The ones that are built around selling your personal information in the form of leads to agents that are paying for it? We're talking thousands, tens of thousands of agents, folks. So you give up a little bit of who you are, you're doomed. Anyway, case in point, we had a couple clients searching on the Big Z site, and they were going there and they were looking for houses prior to them reaching us. And they said that the wife of the husband had informed me that they had to change their email a couple times. They were very thankful that they did register with an email address that they had made up in the very beginning in order just to search for real estate and homes, and they would come back and check. But it was unbelievable how many people were reaching out to them and wanting to solicit them for business. And it wasn't just one or two agents. It was a dozen agents. And if they would have given up a real phone number, that would have also been a problem. So there's your tip of the day. If you're going to search for real estate, and even if you don't trust me, I get it. Because what am I? Well, I'm one of those salespeople that you've heard so much about. What you should do, get a fake email address, something that you, you know, of course, know the username and login, doesn't have to be fancy, and use that to do your real estate registration for all the real estate websites, even an MLSbest.com. No sweat, no harm, no foul. Go ahead and make up a fake email address. You know, I'm searching for real estate at gmail.com, or I'm searching for real estate 1234 at gmail.com. Whatever it is, you can use that. And then you don't have to worry, so your own personal private email that your family and friends and everybody has doesn't get attacked. And then once you get into it a little bit further, we had a couple clients that purchased a house at Stevenson Ranch, and it wasn't until about halfway through the process that they gave up their real email address, the one their family and friends had. But, you know, I was honored. These are very tech-savvy people. They do not like spam. I mean, they're so opposed to it, it's unbelievable. And it took them that long to really decide that, hey, Connor is really being honest with us. He's not going to spam us or trade our information or sell it or anything of the like. He's not going to let it go anywhere, and he's not going to send us an inordinate amount of updates and emails and crap that we don't want. Again, that's a good tip. So if you are going to search for real estate, if you are going to register on a site that requires it, and eventually when you go to MLS Best and do that search, it's going to require some type of registration, use a fake email address that actually works, something that you set up temporarily to do your online real estate searches. I'm Connor McIver. That's your tip of the day. Check out MLSbest.com. It is updated every 7 to 15 minutes, and it is directly from the multiple listing service. Finally, this afternoon, we will have a very cool resource on MLSbest.com called our Lifestyle Search. If you want to see it beforehand, before it's actually up and running on the particular site, it's not going to allow you, if you don't have access to Flash, if you're using a device that doesn't use Flash, you're not going to be able to do it. And some of the devices that come to mind are going to be your iPads and your iPhones. But if you do have an Apple desktop computer or an Apple laptop or whatever it may be, MacBook Pro or Air, it'll work. You just have to download that particular plugin on those sites to be able to view Flash. But you'll be able to use it. The nice thing about it is you select a property, and then you move through the process, you're able to find out market dynamics on that particular listing right there, right in front of you. So it opens up a ghost window, and you'll be able to see those particular neighborhood trends for each one of those properties. That really helps out the data conscience of you out there, those of you that love to chew on real estate data. Find out what those trends are, so you can make the best decisions. I'm Connor McIver. Tomorrow is our REO foreclosure hump day distressed property update. We'll talk a little bit about short sales. A couple things that are coming to the surface, we'll get into that. Maybe hit a little bit on shadow inventory. And of course, talk about those numbers of foreclosures that are out there in the process of developing. Connor McIver, everybody. Thank you so much for listening to our daily real estate radio show. Reach out to us. We, of course, are on social media at Paris911. That's on Twitter. Google Plus, Connor McIver, you can find me. Pretty simple. I'm on there. you'll see a lot of fun stuff there. And, of course, any other systems that we have out there available. Facebook, if you go to facebook.com/Paris911Fans, you'll be able to see that. No spaces and all that. Be safe. We'll talk to you tomorrow, folks. Thank you so much for listening.